testimony finally wrapped up in the Michael Jackson wrongful death trial. Today we heard from a doctor who told the singer propofol was dangerous. Eyewitness News reporter Miriam Hernandez has been covering the trial from the first minutes. She joins us live at the courthouse with today's testimony and what happens next. Miriam.
Mark, what happens next are instructions for the jury, and these instructions are pivotal in this case. These jurors have heard testimony for 82 days. They need very specific guidance on how to weigh a lot of evidence. A key question in the Michael Jackson wrongful death case centers on foreseeability. Attorneys for Katherine Jackson say that AEG knew or should have known that the star for the This Is It tour had a history of prescription drug dependency and should have monitored Conrad Murray, the physician who it turned out was providing him nightly infusions of the anesthetic propofol.
The evidence is clear that Michael Jackson was on a decline for 60 days as written in internal emails that AEG did nothing in supervising Dr. Murray or taking action to stop that.
Attorneys for AEG say Jackson's longtime habit caught up with him.
Michael Jackson was a grown man who kept all of his addictions, including his biggest addiction to propofol, secret, and therefore I think one has to look to personal responsibility here.
The final doctor to testify, Alan Metzger, who treated Jackson for 27 years.
Secretive about medicine, secretive about procedures, secretive about all kinds of stuff.
The doctor says that during the history tour in 1997, he knew about Jackson's problems with insomnia, and so did his close aides. One of the directors on that tour was Paul Gongaware, who later became an AEG executive.
Mr. Gongaware knew, and everyone knew.
Dr. Metzger's recollection on the stand was not clear about Gongaware. The AEG defense says either way, there was no sign to predict Jackson's later pursuit of propofol as a sleep aid.
If they did happen, if in, you know, two tours ago, 20 years before this one, there was actually, he was told that Michael Jackson had problems sleeping. I don't think that says anything but that Michael Jackson had problems sleeping.
Opposing attorneys are similarly polarized on the relevance of Dr. Murray's independent contractor agreement drawn up by AEG. The Jackson attorneys say through it, AEG pressured Murray to provide the propofol.
They are right. It is about responsibility. They just don't want to accept any.
The defense says the tour promoters only facilitated what Jackson wanted.
AEG Live never hired Dr. Conrad Murray.
The jury returns for instructions on Monday morning. Then Tuesday and Wednesday are reserved for closing arguments as well as part of Thursday. It is hoped that by Thursday afternoon, the jury will begin deliberations. Reporting live from downtown Los Angeles, Miriam Hernandez, ABC 7 Eyewitness News.
Miriam, thank you very much.